How come nobody told me about this? What's up, guys? Ranger, and I'm back with a very special reaction. A reaction. I don't think anybody has requested that I do this video, but I actually found it. I was listening to one of the tracks, one of the songs that I have in the playlist, in my playlist, my music playlist, and there was a link over to the side. David Hasselhoff, true survivor from Kung Fury, and it looked like something from the 80s, obviously. And I clicked onto it, and it looked like something from the 80s. But I noticed David looked older. He didn't look like he did in Baywatch or Knight Rider, or even the SpongeBob SquarePants movie. And so I started looking into it, and it turns out I believe this was published or was released last year, and it's a movie actually. So let's go and get on with it. And I'm having to use my other Logitech camera because this movie is 31 minutes, and my other Kodak camera only records for 29. So, and I don't want to split it into two parts. So let's go ahead and get on with it, shall we? Let me double check my camera. Okay, it's still recording. Okay, now I have no idea what this is. Pardon me, really? So, let's just get on with it. I cannot turn autoplay off, so. Also, the video is Laser Unicorns. I'm not completely sure. I believe they might be the ones that made this, but it's on Laser Unicorns channel. The link to it will be below. So let's go ahead and get started again with it. So starting the video on three. Double check. Okay, still recording. Okay, start the video. In 3, 2, 1, click. Laser Unicorn. Wow. Miami 85.
Hey, you got a permit for those guns?
Oh, Chevy Caprice. Right here. Wow. Wow. Okay, that's cool. Okay, well then. Oh, nice Caprice. That's totally CGI. Which I'm glad they didn't actually destroy a nice Caprice. Or Caprices. Okay. Nice music.
Yeah, that's my bicep. 1 second, babe. Hello?
Got an arcane machine down there. Go crazy. It's killing everybody. It's destruction, chaos, and terror. We need...
What are you gonna do?
My job.
Now, this isn't supposed to be serious. A Lambo. Or is that a Ferrari? Sorry, I think Ferrari. Right there, the guy kind of looks like Johnny Depp, but I thought that is him. Uh-oh, man. Oh, they did such a good job replicating those old VHS tapes. What the... It's also interesting how the video plays how the video cuts at the moment. Don't really explain what's going on. It's comical.
Game over. I'm a cop, and damn good at my job. It all began years ago.
Voiceover monologue.
In the line of duty, me and my partner were chasing down a mysterious kung fu master. You're under arrest, punk.
Show us your hand.
Good work, Dragon.
You could have killed both of us with that crazy stunt. But goddammit, you're the best partner I've ever had.
Thanks. I learned from the best. You're like a father to me. With one fatal blow, he hit my partner.
Fatality!
Was dead straight off. Before I could pull the trigger, I was hit by lightning and bitten by a cobra. I blacked out. And saw images of ancient Shaolin temples and monks mastering the art of Kung Fu. There was an ancient prophecy about a new form of Kung Fu so powerful, only one man could master it. The Chosen One.
Kung Fury.
When I woke up, I saw the Kung Fu master running towards me. I could feel my body mutate into some sort of Kung Fu freak of nature.
You are the Chosen One!
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Knuckles.
Flawless victory! Hey, nice! Peterbilt.
As a memento, I put on a strip of
cloth
from the dead Kung Fu master. I decided I would use my new super Kung Fu powers to fight crime.
So again, I love the old, like, VHS tapes, kind of.
I became Kung Fury.
Wow. What? A DeLorean? They did a great job of, like, the homages and everything. Going back to the 80s.
I don't want to hear it, Kung Fury. I just got back from City Hall. $50 million worth of damage.
And the green screen is really good.
I got the hair up my ass like a fag on Viagra. How am I going to explain this to the press? You just destroyed an entire city block, for Christ's sake.
Didn't you tell me to block it out?
Told you to do it by the book.
Cut the bullshit. Nobody else in this apartment could have stopped that arcade machine, and you know it.
Listen to me, Kung Fury. You need to start following the rules, like the rest of us. So I'm assigning you a new partner.
What? Hell no, I work alone.
Not anymore, you don't. Say hi to your new partner, Tricerica.
Very nice meeting you, Kung Fury.
Wow.
Looking forward to working with you.
You're like a father to me. I work alone.
Either you team up with Tricerica, or you're off the case.
I'm not off the case. I quit.
Oh man, I haven't seen those old phones in years.
Yeah, no problem. Give me the phone.
Nazis. Where's Jake and Elwood?
Hell is this? Chief McNichol speaking.
Is this the police?
Yeah, this is the police.
Crack you!
What the freak?
I need someone to trace that call.
But that's impossible.
Not for me, it isn't.
Hacker Man.
He's the most powerful hacker of all time.
I'm getting, Weird Al vibes looking at this guy.
I was able to triangulate the cell phone signal and trace the caller. His name is Adolf Hitler.
Hitler is the worst criminal of all time.
Do you know him, sir?
As you could say that. In the 1940s, Hitler was a kung fu champion. He was so good at kung fu that he decided to change his name to Kung Fury. But he didn't stop there. He knew the Kung Fury prophecy and wanted to claim the throne. So he and his posse of Nazi soldiers conducted
created zombies
for years.
Kung Fu DNA.
They weren't able to figure out how to master the art of Kung Fury. And one day, he disappeared from the face of the earth. And no one has seen him ever since. Until now. I guess he figured if he could find a chosen one and kill him, he would become Kung Fury himself. He must have traveled in time in order to get here. That's probably why he disappeared in the first place.
So what are you gonna do?
My job. I'm gonna go back in time to Nazi Germany and kill Hitler once and for all.
So, how are you gonna do that?
I'm not sure. I need some sort of time machine.
The DeLorean.
Wait a minute. Using an RX modulator, I might be able to conduct a mainframe cell direct and hack the uplink to the download.
What the hell does that mean?
It means that with the right computer algorithms, I can hack you back in time.
What?
Just like a time machine.
Well then.
Okay then.
It's hacking time.
So we're going Tron on this. Is that an Atari? No, that's just no keyboard. Okay. Marty McFly in a nutshell. Wow.
Oh no.
Hacking too much time. He's gonna get stuck back in the past. Or stuck in a time paradox. Or stuck in the digital realm. Or... So, where are we? Okay. Little too far back. Since when
did
they do
that's
that?
That's a laser raptor. I thought they went extinct thousands of years ago.
Dude. I don't think you stand a chance. Then again. Okay then. I take it you're not the only one who time travels then, are you?
Who are you?
My name.
Dragonborn?
It's Barbariana.
Okay.
What year is this?
It's the Viking Age.
What?
That explains the Lysoraptor. Fuck! It went too far back in time.
You need to get out of this valley. This place is swarming with laser raptors. I'll meet you at the God's Drop. Katana can help you get there.
Who?
Who's Katana?
I'm Katana. I can give you a ride to Asgard.
A ride on what?
Okay, then. Okay, now that we're here.
So, who are you?
I'm a cop from the future. I was sent back in time to kill Hitler, but I accidentally went back too far in time. End up in this place.
She probably has no idea who.
I know someone who might be able to help you.
Thor? Thor? The God of Thunder? What are you doing here?
Behold, it is me, Thor, son of Odin and protector of mankind. Check out my pecs.
The pecs are epic.
Thanks, bro.
So... anyway, Thor, this is, Kung Fury. He's a cop from the future.
Yeah, I need to get to Nazi Germany and, kill Hitler, so... if you could help me, then...
Hammer time. Walk through this portal, and you shall end up in Nazi Germany. Good luck to you, Kung Fury.
Thanks, Thor.
And he knows what you're talking about? As does she? Boy, the time-space continuum really is ripped to shreds, isn't it?
This is my ride.
Hey, future cop. Where are you going?
You know what? Here, take my number. And use this phone to call me. It's a personal transportable cellular telephone. It features 645-channel capacity. 10-number speed dial, and an electronic security lock. This revolution in communication could make it possible for more and more people to have a phone in their car.
I'm not even going to ask any questions. Nothing makes sense and it's awesome all the same.
Din mustasch är ju helt kaputt för fan. Den där får du ju avbraken.
Avbraken?
Den ser inte klok ut.
Min mustasch? This is an arisk mustasch.
Nej, this is arisk mustasch. Det där ser ju för fan ut som könshåret på en herrelös hund.
Ja, ja, det var ju lustigt sen ni har sagt det. Det ser ut som du har trillat in i röven med lite lim på läppen bara och dratt tillbaka så det fastnar.
Det här är en arisk mustasch. Man får ju skämmas för det. Det ser inte klokt ut.
This is an Irish mustache. This is how it. This is an. This is a very good mustache.
Ska du börja bölen nu plötsligt också?
This is.
Ska du bölen till mutte? Är du en liten bölen?
Din mustache.
Din mustache, du får ta bort den. Den ser inte klok ut, säger jag.
Mustache tank.
Thank you.
I am the greatest Kung Fu master of all time! Strike eye!
I'm disarming you.
Okay then. How that works, I don't know, but then again, I'm not asking questions.
Kill him!
Again, I would question why wearing the sunglasses at night, but yeah. There's a song that pretty much describes that, so. What the freak? Right now they need like HP bars over top of it, over top of these guys. This guy needs to be a DLC in a future Mortal Kombat. The effects for this are really good. They're comical. They're zany. They're insane. They're fast. And I love the music again. I don't even know.
You don't need that spine.
What the?
It's holding your back.
I'm not even gonna ask how that fit in there. You actually hit him?
Aha. Fuck you, Kung Fury! Now nothing can stop me and my army of death.
Yeah, he ain't dead. He's not dead. Kung Fury mixing ancient history with mythological times since 2015. RoboCop. I had to, yeah. Really? A 1911. Really? Whoa! Kool-Aid for everybody! Oh, they just got de-res. Ah! Okay. Yo, couldn't you reload that 1911 about now?
All right, Hitler. The gig is up. Show me your hand.
Yeah, you can't. Oh, now you got ammo. That's excellent.
Hackerman, Have you seen Kung Fury?
Oh no. We were too late.
Oh, cool. I like this animation. Boy, this is so 80s, man. Laser uniform. Whoa. Wow. I like this animation.
Where are you? My name is Cobra. I've been expecting you.
So where's the Joe when you need him?
I'm your spirit animal.
What the hell is this place?
This is heaven. I'm afraid you're dead.
What? But it looks so real.
Yeah. No, it's totally real.
Mr. Cobra, I'm a police officer. I need you to send me back to Earth. Pronto.
I'm sorry. I can't help you with that. You see, you're dead.
You're under arrest.
What?
I love the over-exaggeration.
Obstruction of justice.
Animation for the character's expression. Oh, man. Oh, you're not dead.
What the hell happened?
I hacked away all of your bullet wounds, Kung Fury.
Thanks.
Okay. Dude, you're screwed. I still say this guy looks like Johnny Depp.
I want to welcome you and your friends to Germany. We are not so different, you and I. I mean,
really?
We both got cool style, you know? We're red, you know? So that's cool.
Hitler trying to be Hitler.
We both like doing moves. Yeah, check it out. Yeah, yeah. And killing people. I love it. You clearly do too. And that's cool.
You can't tell me this guy does not look like Johnny Depp.
Join me. We could be brothers. We are so alike. It's almost like we finish each other's
balls.
What?
My, not much left of him, is there?
The important thing is that he's gone. Sorry I doubted you, Triceracop. You're the best damn partner I've ever had.
I came back in time for you, Kung Fury. Because, dammit, I love you.
Teamwork is very important.
You can talk?
So, what happens now, Kung Fury?
Well, I need to head back to the office. Looks like it's gonna be a hell of a lot of paperwork.
Well, if you defeated him in the past, then that means... Yep.
Open the doors, Hoff.
I'm sorry, Fury.
Oh my!
I can't let you do that.
Open the doors, Hoff.
I'm sorry. I can't let you open the doors, Kung Fury.
God damn it, open the doors.
I'm sorry. I can't
open the doors.
This is totally not right.
Did anyone ever tell you not to hassle the Hoff 9000?
Oh, Hoff 9000. Son of a bitch. Piece of shit.
Hello.
left of him, is there?
The important thing is that he's gone. He's gone.
That symbol before. Somewhere.
Really?
Hitler.
That's a really beautiful shot of Miami. Dedicated to the old man. David Sandberg, okay. Take our love away from here. We need a living passion to believe in. Burning hearts and a brand new feeling. Action! If we're gonna make it like a true survivor. The hero stands alone. When all is said and done, the enemies are falling one by one. Lamborghini Countach. Swedish Film Institute, okay. The dinosaurs were expected in the making of this movie. Okay, I got Laser Unicorn Productions. Okay, okay, I gotta stop it before moving Sweden. Okay, I gotta stop it here before the autoplay continues. Okay, now, I can honestly say that was an incredible short film, basically. That was an incredible film. Now, so much to say regarding this. Now, like I said, first off, I had no idea that this even existed. Pardon me. I had no idea that this even existed. And that I know of, nobody had mentioned this to me. I apologize if somebody did and I completely forgot about it. But I didn't even know that this existed. And I was, like I said, I was listening to one of my music, or one of the electronic tracks in my 80s, 70s, 80s, 90s playlist, and I noticed the link over on the side to the music video of David Hasselhoff performing that final song in this film, and I checked it out, and it led me to Kung Fury, and so I started watching it, and like I said, I mean, in the music video, David Hasselhoff is older. I mean, this looks like something from the 80s, but with a bit of the camera work, you can tell that it's, you know, more modern. But again, I started watching the music video, and I'm like, okay, this is David Hasselhoff is in this, and there's not a yellow sponge in sight, I gotta say, this is really good. This was a short film, and this is just completely crazy and zany, and it's pretty much an homage and a kind of a parody, in a sense, of all of the memorable things, or many of the memorable things about the 80s. I mean, the arcades, and in a lot of 80s cop shows, like Kung Fu,
and like the cop dramas of the 80s. You had in late 70s, 80s, you had Chips, you had Adam 12 in the 70s, T.J. Hooker of the 80s, Starsky and Hutch of late 70s, and so this was just phenomenal. And then again, references to I'm thinking to RoboCop, Back to the Future, Xena. I apologize if I'm pronouncing that incorrectly, but that, and then like some of those kung fu films of the 80s, and then there was things that I kept thinking, this is like Mortal Kombat here. And then Knight Rider out there with David Hasselhoff, who was in Knight Rider, just phenomenal. And then you cannot have something in the 80s with and have a sports car without it being a Lamborghini or a Ferrari. And excellent use, excellent CGI work for the 80s Chevy Caprice patrol cars. Very beautiful design. I'm pretty sure that they did, you know, get some basic designs, you know, looked at the actual cars to get every single detail accurate. They probably maybe even scan the cars themselves to be able to actually render them and actually use them. But I've seen that done before. And I think it was in one of the Final Destination films. They did a phenomenal job with that. Like I said, the details for the cars and everything was incredible. The Lamborghini Countach, man, beautiful car. The Chevy Caprices, beautiful cars. And then, just out of nowhere, zany things. And again, I mean, to everybody that worked on this film, to everybody that worked on writing on this film, to everybody that worked on the choreography, the editing, you know, music, audio, or the audio, the CGI, the animation sequence, like the green screen effects, to everybody that worked on this, I cannot thank you guys enough. This is an incredible film. This is an incredible short film. And it's not to be taken seriously. I mean, it's pure for pure comedy purposes. And this is just incredible. And again, so first off, to everybody that worked on this, to everybody, Laser Unicorn Productions, everybody there, to everybody that worked on this in every single department, thank you guys so much for working on this. Thank you so much for making this. Thank you so much to every single person involved with the creation of this. This is just phenomenal. So two thumbs up. That's as many thumbs as I have to give. If I had more thumbs, I would give more. So thank you so much. This is an incredible piece. This is an incredible short film. And like I said, just so much done. The animation itself, like the animated scene, the animation scene whenever Kung Fury died right there. That again, the animation was really well done. It had a modern essence to it. Yet at the same time, it definitely did a fantastic job of looking like some of the animations that you would have seen back in the 80s. And then the music was great as well. The music was phenomenal. The background scenes were just awesome. I mean, you could tell that it was all green screen effect, but they did a really good job. I mean, they did a really good job. I mean, obviously, I mean, I could tell that, you know, that it wasn't real, that it was fake. Yet at the same time, I mean, I can easily look over that because of how this film is supposed to be. Now, a film that is supposed to be more serious, having, you know, these kind of effects, some, you know, like one of the James Bond films, I can't remember which one it was, but it was the one where Bond was having to try to surf over water, and there was like a lot of icebergs that was causing the water to rise up, and some people, you know, said that was very horrible green screen effect. And so, you know, for this right here, in that kind of film, you can't really look over it because of the nature of what the film is supposed to be, what it's supposed to live up to. This, however, is supposed to be a comedy, and so I can easily look over any little mishap like that. And also, the costume designs were awesome. It gave a really awesome, like, 80s vibe to it. The costume designs were great. The music editing was great. The backgrounds were just phenomenal as well. Obviously, they had to get probably some possibly some stock footage of Miami to be able to use in it. The rest of the backgrounds, though, they were able to create in the editing process and such. And so they did a really good job with that. And again, it was just comical. The choreography, again, for like the fighting scenes was just really, really well done. Again, it combined live action performance and CGI, you know, the green screen effect and everything. Pardon me. But again, it was really, really well done. It was comical. It was absolutely freaking hilarious. And this is definitely, I mean, there was a lot of gore in this, yet at the same time, it was comical. It wasn't like horror movie gore in the terms of it's actually in the intent to scare you. And so it was just comical in how that it was actually done. And then, like, the zaniness of just the out-of-place, like, the out-of-nowhere characters, like, Triceratops, and then the hacker, who I also say looked like a sort of a younger version of Weird Al. And so, I mean, just completely out of left field. Actually, this went farther than left field. And so, I mean, there was just so much going on in this film. So many, like, references to, like, the 80s, like the old arcades and music, like the neon lights and some of that, and just the setting and what was going on in some of it, and then the use of having Hitler come back was just completely crazy, out of left field. And then, you know, they remained true to, at the same time that this was completely crazy, at the same time, they managed to remain true to some of the essence of the 80s itself, using the cars like that, and then using the older style computers, and, like, the old cassette player, and then having those old, huge, bulky phones. I mean, I've never seen one in real life myself, those old, big, blocky phones. But, I mean, I'm sure somebody has, possibly that watches my channel, that watches my videos. And so, again, it's one of those things where you look at just how far technology has come along from that big, huge, blocky, like, walkie-talkie-style phone to this very small, thin phones. And, wow. But while the phones have got more smaller and, okay, cars have pretty much done exactly like phones, got more smaller and compact. But, again, this is just completely crazy. It was awesome in that. I mean, again, this wasn't to be taken seriously. It was just more complete for comedy. And so this is just completely crazy. And whenever I mean, just like right now, I'm on here. And I can see that another, like, quite a bit of people have actually done reactions to this, but none of the people that I'm seeing over here currently that have done reactions to this and commentary and reviewed it are anybody that I am currently subscribed to. So I implore you, I encourage you, please send this film, request it to every other reactor, because I want to see their reactions to this. And if you do reactions, please watch this film. Please watch this film. Watch it for yourself. I want to hear your commentary on this. I want to check it out. So again, please send this video to other people that does reactions as well, because again, I want to see other people's reactions. I want to hear their commentary. I would love to hear other people's commentary on this, and I would love to see other people's reactions to the zaniness, incredibleness that is Kung Fury. And obviously, I don't know if you can actually do a reaction to the music video, but I'm just going to tell you right now, the link to the music video will be below as well. Please check it out. David Hasselhoff can really sing. I did not know that. I apologize for that, but I did not know. But he can really sing. It's a really good music video. It's a very good homage to the 80s. So please check it out. It's a really great music video as well. And please, I'm not sure if people can do a reaction to that, considering it's a music video. But if they can, please send it to them as well, or just let them do commentary on it. But again, I want to see other people's reactions to this film as well, and hear their commentary, and hear their reviews on this. And so, again, everybody involved with this film, thank you so much. And thank you guys again for joining me. I hope you enjoyed. And please let me know what you think about this film in the comments below. And just any other information that you want to share regarding this film, what you learned, please feel free to put it in the comments below as well. And again, anything you want to say about this film, please, please, please do. And if you haven't watched my reaction and commentary or my reaction to it, and you still want to watch it and you want to do a reaction, then please link your reaction in the comments below so that I can check that out as well, so that everybody else can check it out as well. So thank you guys again for joining me, and I will see you guys again next time with the next video that I do. Take care.